When you need advice, come to Ben and Kelly. It's group therapy on 99.7 DJX.
All right, let me toss the phone number out real quick. 502-571-9970. Would love to hear, especially if you can relate to our listener here with group therapy. Kelly, describe what group therapy is.
Well, this is a place that you can come and get advice on an issue you're struggling with that maybe you can't go to your family or friends with.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, so thanks for allowing us to call you. Walk us through what you sent us, if you would.
Yeah, okay. So the other day I was using my boyfriend's computer, and there's this folder on the desktop. I've never seen it before. It's untitled, and I just automatically clicked it.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Like, but it was, like, unconscious. And by the time it opened, I felt really bad. But then I saw these pictures of him and his ex, and they were, like, boudoir photos of her and pictures of them on vacation together. And, okay, so they broke up 4 years ago.
Uh-huh.
It's not, like, a recent breakup, and they've never been there before. And she broke his heart, and, like, it always seems like he has residual feelings because he talks about their breakup and how painful it was. So
still?
So yeah.
Oh. Okay.
And
okay.
Now this folder shows up?
Yeah, I was going to say. So you're on your boyfriend's computer. You see this folder on his desktop. You click on it. You open it. And there are these photos, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And there's videos, too.
Videos?
Yeah. Videos of them on vacation and bed together. And he's, like, looking at her in ways that he's never looked at me before. I don't know. I'm just freaking out. I don't even know if he can love me the way he obviously loved her like he does in those photos and videos.
I mean, I feel like we all keep photos from, like, past relationships, right? So that...
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if that's a red flag, right?
Yeah, but, like, watching videos, it just seems different, like... You know, more intimate in the fact that the folder just appears out of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Am I blowing this out of proportion? Do I bring it up with him? Like, without shaming him or accusing him of not being over her. I don't want to seem like a crazy ex.
Right.
Or not a crazy ex, a crazy psycho digging through all his stuff. But, yeah. Like, I don't know what to do. Do I forget about it? Do I move forward? Do I confront him?
Yeah. That's weird. It is weird, and I am going to, like, agree with you that it is weird that he just has a folder of these pictures and videos on his computer, and it's unmarked. It's almost like he's hiding them in plain sight, which is weird.
Yeah.
Right.
And they've never been there before. Like, he uses his computer all the time, and then suddenly this folder's there.
Oh. It's almost like he found them on, like, an old memory card or something and then dropped them on the... Yeah, that's weird. Okay, so we got a bunch of people chiming in, texting. Yeah, hang out, and hopefully we'll be able to steer you in a direction to make you feel more comfortable about what's happening.
Thank you. I really appreciate that.
No problem, and definitely keep us updated on what you find out there.
I get what she means, what she says about, you know, the videos being a little bit more intimate. I mean, I've got, I think, a handful of old pictures in a box buried somewhere in the house.
But you're not, like, getting them out every week and looking at them.
Exactly. And Tanya's like, good Lord, I have pics of old boyfriend all around somewhere. I also have old papers I wrote for college, websites I bookmarked and never go to, recipes I typed and never cooked. Sometimes it's just clutter. I keep all pictures because one time I threw out an old boyfriend's photos, he died in a car wreck. I regretted not having those letters and pictures so much. Judge your relationship by the quality, not by a folder on a computer.
See, now Katie says the opposite. She's like, so you want to forget about a whole folder of an ex he has from 4 years ago? Absolutely not. You need to run. He seems like a Joe Jr. from Netflix's You. See the red flag. Man. All right. So would
love. Dang. Yeah. People are kind of like on opposite ends of the spectrum on this on Facebook. Some of them are just like, not a big deal. Don't worry about it. But then others are like, huge red flag.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I'm like her. It's the videos that really bother me the most. And, you know, seeing him interact with his ex like that would bother me too.
How do we navigate this? And this is where we kind of need you to give us a way and a direction to go, because I don't have a box of or a folder of ex, you know, pictures of exes or anything like that. So I can't really relate. I know my wife has a box maybe similar to you of, you know, some old photos that may contain some, you know, ex-boyfriends or things like that. But yeah.
How would you feel though if you found a computer folder with a bunch of pictures and videos and stuff like that?
I'd probably delete it.
How would you feel?
I'd probably just delete
it. Oh,
all right. I don't know what happened to it. 502-571-9970. On the computer.
Well, and then she was caught kind of snooping a little bit. So now we need to try to figure out, okay, can she like admit that she clicked on this and what she found and ask him about it, which many people are just like, yeah, you just need to tell him what happened. Just like, listen, this folder didn't have a name. I clicked on it
and
found all this stuff.
And this is what I found. So what gives, man?
Yes.
Hey, Jenna, so what's your thought?
Exes are kind of like that cake you ate last night. You don't want to see it. You want to know that it was there, but you don't want to see the evidence. So ask him politely why it's on his computer, and if he wants to give the pictures back to her, he can. They can meet somewhere and he can give them back to her, or he could politely put them somewhere and hide them in the back of the closet, because unless she wants to show his exes to him, I don't think he'd feel like seeing them.
All right, Jenna, appreciate it. Thank you. Hey, Lauren, so what's your approach on this?
It seems a little sketchy, to be honest with you, but I mean, the part that really kind of got me about it was when she was like, you know, should I just forget about it? Honestly, I don't think it's something that she can just forget about. You
right.
know what I mean? Like, it's always going to be in the back of her mind. Like, it'd be in the back of my mind for sure.
But you're seeing red flags here.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I feel bad for her. I feel, like, really sad if I saw that too, you know?
Yeah.
Bless your heart.
I know. It's just, we just need a big bless your heart. Like,
I know.
Oh my gosh. All right. Well, hey, Lauren, maybe I can get her number and you guys can go out drinking some night.
Right.
Okay. All right. Hey, take care. Thank you.
Thanks.
Hey, Jonathan. So what's your thought?
I actually have been the guy that has the folder on his computer.
Okay. So from a guy's perspective, what's happening here?
I don't know if he was not aware, because, I mean, if it's on his desktop, there's a lot of icons on there. Sometimes you just don't notice it. Sometimes, if I work in the IT industry, and depending if he's running a Mac computer, if he's restored his computer, that folder could have just been restored and he not know about it. But I do know, like I said, I was the guy that had the folder on his computer, and it was just pictures, like, from the relationship, nothing intimate or anything like that, and
right.
I got confronted, and I was like, 100%, I have no clue, didn't even know it was there, I had restored the computer, and I was like, here, delete, trash can, empty recycle bin.
All right, Jonathan, thank you, man.
That could very well be, because she had mentioned that kind of, it just appeared, and she, yeah. And she hadn't seen it before. Now, Kim is rolling in on Facebook going, I'm sure this will be the unpopular opinion because everyone is so pro. He's got a problem. What a psycho. You should run, because that's always what 90% of this crap says. But it's a different day and age. I have a box
right,
of old
though.
Love letters.
She's right.
Laying it down.
She's right. It yep. almost always is, that person's got to go.
Yes. And she says, I've got a box of old love letters and pictures from high school. It wouldn't have been any different in my opinion to have found that, and I don't think he accidentally, without thinking, clicked it. I say it's your issue, not his. They had a relationship that eventually ended, but I'm sure it wasn't all bad. It's part of his past and who he is. He has a relationship with you at this point, so if you can't communicate openly and trust him, then you need to be done.
Or you do what Michael suggests and say, Photoshop your face on every single picture, and if he gets upset, leave.
That is a little psycho. But no, most people are just like, listen, just tell them, like, I clicked on this folder, didn't have a name, and this is what I found. So,
I
like,
that's how you got to approach it.
Yeah. I mean, you just tell the truth. That's exactly what happened. You didn't know what it was.
And then you're going to figure out quickly if he's still, like, actively looking and pining over his ex.
Yes. Like, his reaction to that will tell you a lot, I think.
Right. All right. Well, if you were listening and you're like, man, I couldn't get through, or I think they're wrong.
Communication. We're not wrong. You just got to talk to him about it.
Then you can always go over to the Facebook page and leave a comment there at Ben and Kelly Show.